to see you again.
Hi,
Nish. Hi. We met 2 years ago on Embedded as well, right?
Yes.
And then you showed me something that you already have on your stand, but it has developed since then. Can you talk a bit about this little guy?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. This is a previous version of our Eve. And Eve is our embedded video engine.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a controller that allows graphic displays to be run by an MCU,
mm-hmm.
Simply over SPI or quad SPI.
Right.
So the last time I showed you this, we were talking about a 4x4 vehicle. And this inclinometer would be on the dashboard.
Oh, right.
So since then, we've moved on.
Generation number 5.
Generation 5, so.
So this is your product, which is actually future-proof. So this is how you prepare for the future development of embedded solutions.
Absolutely.
Uh-huh.
So the first thing you'll notice in the demo that we're showing is the screen's much bigger.
Mm-hmm,
the resolution's much higher.
Right.
And that's the key parts of the fifth generation Eve.
Mm-hmm.
Again, it uses the SPI to talk from a microcontroller.
But everything is on one chip because you've got graphics, touch, and audio. So all the functions on one chip, which means that it is using less energy. This is more reliable. You don't need peripherals for it, right?
Correct.
And then it, for the client, it's much better to use like the compact version. Yeah?
Yes. Mm-hmm. And if you've got an existing microcontroller in your project, you can already use it. You don't need to replace it.
Yeah.
As long as I mentioned before, you're using the SPI connection.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But as well, I was reading about it and I read that those products are also bridging the technology between machines and people as well, but also between the older solutions, like maybe some legacy business solutions and newest technologies.
Correct.
Yeah?
Yes, absolutely. We have seen previous images, products where somebody's used a mechanical switches and buttons. Let's replace it with a graphics touchscreen, and you get so much more to do on a touchscreen than just pressing buttons. So.
And this is the perfect example.
And this
of
is
such
the perfect example.
Uh-huh.
But then there's one other thing we haven't mentioned yet of the fifth generation, and it's the video in.
Okay.
Previous generations didn't have that.
And what does it do, video in?
So I'll show you. It uses LVDS and it allows you to have a live feed from a camera over HDMI to the display.
Okay, yes.
And
then I see two pictures over here.
Yes.
Two moving pictures, one the larger one and this is the smaller one. How did you do it?
So we're calling this one is the photo booth. And it's basically to give you an idea of the power of the controller here. We can actually have two live videos and you can see it's still running live and you can move about, we're still getting the control. The idea of this demo is like a photo booth. You can put on emojis and stuff and take a photo of yourself.
Okay.
We're just trying a new way to show, how do we show off this new capability?
Resolution is great.
Absolutely.
As I can see, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so who is using that? Who, for example, is using, which industries are using those this feature that it can be divided into two?
So,
what else give us?
Well, there's a few options, but the first customers we've been seeing may be security, where you're looking at more than one camera, or it could be a front doorbell type thing, action, or door access, anything like that. Some examples.
Are there any potential trends that you might not have considered yet in this equipment? What is going to be the future of it? Or is it so great that you think it's got it all?
Well, as you see, this is our fifth generation. Now, of course, I want to say it's got it all, but we're always looking ahead. So we will be looking if what else is required out there. But at the moment, we believe, because this is so up to date with the high resolution and with these different features that we've added in, it should be good to go.
For me, like, I'm a layman a little bit, but for me, when the microcontroller is inside and it gathers some data and then it sends it to me, it needs to be like on time, visible, right in front of my eyes, and I need to be able to read it as quickly as possible. And this is what you do, this is this bridging.
Absolutely. You can see the Eve chip is taking away all the graphic power that an MCU would require. So the MCU can do other things, whatever else the product's in it's controlling. And our chip is taking all the power from the graphics. And as you can see, with this high resolution, it's going to need a lot of graphical power to be able to do that.
Can you show me other features? Where should I press?
for an example, this is like a photo booth, so you might want to take a photo of yourself. Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. Why not add some emojis? Why don't you try it?
I just take one.
Okay.
Yeah? Okay. And I put it over here.
And you chose the sad one.
Sorry. I will choose the evil one. Evil better.
Yeah. And you can easily take a screenshot and send that to your friends.
Okay, wait. There is Alex standing. Just stand there. Just don't move. Don't move, Alex. Don't move. Okay. That's much better. Yes. I like it.
Suits my shirt.
Yeah,
it does.
Right. Red face and pink shirt. What else would you ask for? Okay. So, what ways do you use to strengthen the reputation on the market, brand's presence on the market?
So, the reputation is basically precedes itself because we've had four previous generations, mm-hmm. and on this table we've got some of the previous generations, and mm-hmm. behind you we have the last generation, which was the fourth.
Yeah.
So these chips have been out for a long time. Mm-hmm. People use them, mm-hmm. but then they want more. They
exactly.
want a bigger resolution, they want yeah. a bigger screen. Mm-hmm. So we've given them more by going to this fifth generation.
And you are listening to the client. And when they are choosing any kind of this embedded video engine,
yep.
there are different companies doing it, but they come back to you because you are offering them some specific yeah. features.
Yeah, well, we're unique in this three-in-one solution, mm-hmm. as far as we're aware, mm-hmm. That we offer this. And again, I keep going back to, you can use it on an existing microcontroller. It yeah. doesn't need to be that powerful.
Mm-hmm. I want to see those things.
Sure, right.
Because we started with them.
Yes.
And when I put them on the hand, what is it?
Okay, so this has
what
got, we call this a credit card module, because uh-huh. it's the size and shape of a credit card.
You're right.
And it has the 820 IC on it,
mm-hmm.
and it has external memory that we've mentioned here.
Yeah.
And the modules together mm-hmm. is a complete development kit. Mm-hmm. So if you hook them up to a display,
I need nothing else.
We have tools. We have software mm-hmm. tools. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you can download.
As far as hardware.
As far as hardware, just these mm-hmm. and the display.
Okay. Okay. And the smaller one.
Yep. So this. It's the same module you can see that's plugged in the top.
Yeah.
So again, this is the 820, and this is called our mini module.
Uh-huh.
So the idea of the mini module is a customer might just put that straight into their product.
But also the fifth generation?
This is the exact same chip.
Uh-huh. Okay.
The fifth generation.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is like after the credit card, all right,
yeah.
and this one with the size?
Yeah, so this is mini module. So mm-hmm. the reason with credit card, that's if you want to develop. So
mm-hmm.
you take that away, program mm-hmm. away to you,
mm-hmm.
and then you can have it running.
Mm-hmm.
And the idea of this one could go straight onto your board,
mm-hmm.
And you could prototype, or indeed put this straight into your product.
Okay, right, great. And I think the last question from me, which I'm always very interested in, because the industries, automotive, healthcare, smart homes, which of those is pushing the boundaries the most for embedded solutions?
Yeah. Automotive, mm-hmm. I would say.
Automotive.
Winter. We've yeah. seen more and more displays in mm-hmm. automotive, especially going to electric cars, electric scooters,
yeah.
that kind of thing.
When you are driving your car,
yes.
and you see the display, do you see the difference? And you think Bridgetek is inside, or oh, they don't have it?
Well, my current car is a touch display,
okay.
And the previous one was the rotary.
Uh-huh.
Which is a vast improvement. So you
mm-hmm.
see it in industry, don't you? Especially automotive. It's a big leaps and bounds that comes on.
So you prefer automotive with touch displays, and this is your way of looking at embedded?
I
yeah?
do, but there's a mm-hmm. slight argument to that, right?
Yeah, what
is
it?
You can't do everything on a touchscreen while you're driving, right?
True.
You still need a steering wheel.
Yeah,
with controls.
You need some buttons here.
Yes, you can't rely
to
on
change the
radio or for example,
yeah.
or the sat nav.
Yeah, and sometimes when I have the touch screen and I'm touching it, this is true that I cannot hit the proper piece.
Exactly.
On it. Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, I know.
And some, particularly electric cars, they're just mainly the touch screen.
Yeah.
But I believe you should still have some buttons, especially when driving.
I'm thinking, or just it came up to my mind.
Right.
When planes are going to be with no buttons, but only touchscreen.
Yes.
Only nothing else, it's huge touchscreen. I don't want that.
No.
I think I like buttons. So I think the best solution is just to combine this perfect touchscreen and your perfect microcontroller or microchip plus the knobs and the buttons, and then we
definitely
are all happy.
There's still going to be space in the market for both. Mm-hmm. But there's some applications like we have here that is just purely display. Mm-hmm. For example, if we go back to the inclinometer, it's mm-hmm. only you don't need to change anything on that. You're just viewing it as you're driving along. Mm-hmm.
So, and people actually using it are used to the view, right?
Exactly.
And they it became friendly for them.
Yes.
Yeah. I get that.
But then back to the fifth generation, mm-hmm. with the camera, there's so many different applications out there mm-hmm. that you could use it in different industries. Out with automotive, you mentioned automotive.
Yeah.
But there's security cameras and these kind of...
Yeah, but I think like as well, for me, the most fascinating is medical area when
yes.
they've got touch screens, right?
Yeah.
They can just perform examinations on us. They see the results, they scan, and they
yes.
see exactly the picture. And it must be perfect resolution.
It must
Nothing
be.
Nothing to
yes.
be lost, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I know AI is doing it for us, but still we need to also be able to see it.
And another application I've thought of myself is in electronics testing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when you're using a digital microscope,
okay.
you'll
yeah.
have the digital image
uh-huh.
it's from the camera straight in here,
yeah.
And you can use that for fault finding. So it's another example.
Right. And this is going, I think, to bring younger generation and children to such displays, because when there is the microscope with the camera, they are used to screens.
Yes.
And when there is just, you know, the lens in the laboratory equipment, they don't find it attractive.
Absolutely. And again, it's just showing one of the newer features of this new IC.
Yes, yes. I like it.
Good.
I like a little black cubic thing that gives me everything I need. Audio, touch, display, and it communicates.
Yeah.
I think the interview was so great that I'm going to give it like, yay! How do you like? How many hands? Yay! Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Gavin, it was great. You see?
Nice
Gavin.
To meet you again,
nice.
Agnes.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye.